Hello and welcome to this new lesson. In this lesson, you will learn how your programs can make decisions. Let's look at an example. Here you have a typical elevator panel, and yes, elevators are controlled by computers these days. And if you look at the buttons, you'll notice that there are buttons for 10, 11, 12, and then it goes on with 14. So there's no button for 13, and that's of course because many people are superstitious and don't want to be in the 13th floor of a building. Now, contrary to popular belief, the 13th floor is not filled with secret government offices. There actually is a 13th floor. They just call it the 14th. So the software that controls the elevator car needs to adjust for this human foible. Here's how you can do that in Java. Let's say floor is the number as provided by the user, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, or whatever. And now we want to compute the actual floor. Then we need to make a decision. In Java, you use the if statement to make decisions, and you enclose the condition in parentheses. Then you use a pair of braces, and inside you put the statement or statements that you want to have executed when this condition is true. So if the floor is greater than 13, then we want to adjust by subtracting 1. On the other hand, if the condition is false, then we'll carry out the actions in the else part of the statement, in which case the actual floor number equals the floor number without an adjustment. And that's all there is to it. Let's go over the important parts again. The keyword if starts out the conditional statement. The condition goes in here and is surrounded by parentheses. If the condition is true, then the part following the if is executed. And if the condition is false, then the part after the else clause is executed. All right, now it's your turn. In some Asian countries, it's not the number 13 that brings bad luck, but the number 14, and those elevators wouldn't have a number 14. And in fact, just to play it safe, some property owners will eliminate both the 13 and the 14. So go ahead and modify the program in the next exercise so that it translates the user-selected number to the actual floor number. And no, there are no hidden floors with secret government offices.